Hi everyone, my name is Busa Adiabiodun. Welcome to my channel. In this video, I'm going to discuss about subsidiary book, which is otherwise known as the day book or book of original entry. Under this topic, we'll be looking at the meaning of subsidiary book, the types of day book we have, and the format of a day book. And in this particular video, we will be treating a sales day book. So subsidiary book, what is subsidiary book? Like I said, subsidiary book is also known as book of original entry, book of prime entry, or the day book. It is a book in which accounting record are first recorded from source document before being transferred to the relevant account in the ledger. So like I said, if you are talking about the subsidiary book, the day book, the journal, it is the same thing. But at times, some big organization keep a day book separate from the journal, that is a day book as an extension of the journal. In preparation, it is the same way we prepare the two, but in that case, it is just to control the likely error that may occur. That's the reason why a day book is being kept separated from a journal. At the end of the day, organization that does that, at the end of the day, they will transfer the total amount from the day book into the journal. But a situation whereby an organization does not keep a day book separate from the journal, it means the journal play the role of the day book. So, types of day book. The day book can be classified into the following. We have the sales day book, which is also known as the sales journal. We have purchase day book, return inward day book, return outward day book. We have the cash book, and we have the general journal. Those are the classes of the day book that we have. We will be taking this day book one after the other. If you are talking about this, the sales day book, a sales day book is used to record items that are being sold on credit. That is, only credit items that are recorded in a sales day book. If you are talking about the purchase day book, that is, only credit purchases are recorded in the purchase day book. If you are talking about return inward day book, when a credit customer returns goods to the business, the book in which the business record those return, we call those return inward. The book is called the return inward book or return inward journal. Where at the same time, the business will not take the responsibility. All those goods returned by the customer, they will also return it back to the supplier. So when the business is returning goods to the supplier, the book in which they are going to record those items being returned back to the supplier is called the return outward book. Why the cash book? The cash book is used to record cash transaction. That is, when the business receive cash from customer, they enter it into the cash book. When they make cash payment, they enter it into the cash book. But in the case of the general journal, this is used to record all the transactions that cannot be recorded in the other books that are mentioned above. Before I move further, let's remember that if you are talking about transactions, there are two types of transaction. It's either you transact in cash or on credit. A situation whereby a business deal only on cash transaction, such business may not need other books. Only the cash book may be required, but any business that deal with credit transaction will surely need all these day book that we explain. So let's look at the format of a day book. So this is how the format of a day book is. We have the date, we have the particulars where the items that have been purchased will be recorded, we have the folio, and we have the details where the amount of each of the items will be detailed, and we have the amount at the last side where the total of the items being bought by a customer will be recorded. So now, the sales day book, just like I said, this is used to record the details of goods sold on credit to customers. In this case, only items with original intention for buying them are for sale, are entered into the sales day book when such items are sold on credit. So just like I said, if you are talking about sales in business, the items that is regarded as sales are those items that are being purchased with the original intention of being sold. So that is the item that is called sales. So whenever we sell those items on credit, the book in which we are going to record it is called the sales day book. So let us take an illustration. Under the sales day book, the following transactions are records of credit sales of Alabi Trading Store for the month of April 2020. April 10 sold 5 bags of rice to Jumia, 12,000 naira per bag. April 18, Andrew bought 2 gallons of groundnut oil at 15,000 naira per gallon, 2 bags of rice at 12,000 naira per bag, 10 kg of beans at 500 naira per kg, less 5% trade discount. April 27, Olaoluwa Stores bought 10 bags of rice at 10,000 naira per bag, less 5% trade discount. You are required to prepare the sales day book. You are required to prepare the sales day book or journal for the month of April 2020. So just like I said, so take down this question: why will we be treating the items one after the other? So just like I said, we prepare our format with date, particulars, folio, details, and amount. That is the format for all the day book. The only difference will be with the heading, where we have sales day book or sales journal. Now let's start taking the items one after the other. April 10 sold 5 bags of rice to Jumia at 12,000 naira per bag. Who are we selling to? Jumia. So with me, the first thing is that we write the date, April 10. Then the name, Jumia, and don't forget to put your denomination. If it is naira, you put your naira sign. If it is dollar, you put the dollar sign. So then what did we sell to Jumia? 5 bags of rice. So we enter the transaction, 5 bags of rice at 12,000 naira per bag. So the 5 bags will be 12,000 naira times 5, which is 60,000 naira. So we enter it under the detail, this 60,000 naira. So no other entry again, we close it, then we have the amount 60,000 naira, which means the amount that Jumia is owing us is 60,000 naira. Next, April 18, Andrew bought 2 gallons of groundnut oil at 15,000 naira per gallon, 2 bags of rice at 12,000 naira per bag, 10 kg of beans at 500 naira per kg, less 5% trade discount. The first thing is that we identify who is the debtor, Andrew. That is April 18, Andrew. We enter the name. Then we start taking the items. What are those items that Andrew bought from us? 2 gallons of groundnut oil at 15,000 naira per gallon. We enter it. 2 gallons of groundnut oil at 15,000 naira per gallon. So that will be 2 times 15, 30,000 naira. That's the first item. Then the next item is what? 2 bags of rice at 12,000 naira per bag. We enter that. 2 bags of rice at 12,000 naira per bag. 2 times 12. That's 24. Then he also bought beans. So what? 10 kg of beans at 500 naira per kg. We also enter that. 10 kg of beans at 500 naira per kg. That will be 10 times 500 naira, which is 5,000 naira. That is all about what Andrew bought from us. But don't forget that Andrew is giving 5% trade discount. This first thing is that we are going to calculate the total. What is the total amount of the goods bought by Andrew? If we had everything together, it's going to give us 59,000 naira. It is on this amount that this count will be given to Andrew. So that means we are going to calculate 5% of 59,000. So that will now be less 5% trade discount. If we calculate 5% of 59,000, that is going to give us 2,950. If we subtract 2,950 from 59,000, the So we close it, then the balance will be 56,050 naira, which means the total amount Andrew is owing us is 56,050 naira. So the next entry we have Ololuwa store. So April 27, who bought 10 bags of rice at 12,000 naira per bag, less 5% trade discount. The first thing, we identify the buyer, which is Ololuwa store. So April 27, Ololuwa store. What did Ololuwa store bought from us? So 10 bags of rice at 12,000 naira per bag. That will be 12,000 naira times 10, which is 120,000 naira. No other items. So that means it's given discount. Then that will be less 5% trade discount. If we calculate 5% of 120,000 naira, it's going to give us 6,000 naira. So we close the entry. So then we subtract 6,000 naira from 120,000 naira. The balance will be 114,000 naira. As there is no other entry again, so that means we are going to add everything together. If we add everything together, it's going to give us 230,000 naira, which means at the end of the month of April, the total amount of credit sales by the business is 230,000 naira. With and based on what you are having, Jumia is owing us 60,000 naira. Andrew is owing us 56,050 naira, while Ololua is owing us 114,000 naira. So this amount, the 230,000 naira, is what will be transferred to the sales ledger. So which means by the time we are preparing the account, the 230,000 naira will be transferred into the credit side of the sales ledger, while we are going to open personal account, which is debtors account for Jumia, Andrew, and Ololuwa. Which means under Jumia account, we are going to debit Jumia with 60,000 naira. We are going to debit Andrew with 56,050 naira. We are going to debit Ololuwa with 114,000 naira. If you don't understand this, you can check out my video on ledger. You understand it better. Which means those are the relevant accounts in the ledger, which we said those items will be transferred. So don't so thank you very much. This is where we are stopping it. In our next video, we will be discussing about purchase the book. Before you go, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, like the video, share the video with others. And until the next lesson, we will be meeting. I say bye for now.